Wait, one more.
One more inch, tiny little bit, and stop. All right, guys, we got the F430 loaded up, so without further ado, let's go ahead and start the 3-hour drive up to fab speed. Here we go. Hello, fab speed.
We made it.
After 3 hours,
speed
we
shop.
Have arrived.
No joke.
All right, guys, climbed in the F430. The final start with stock exhaust. Sounds good, but it's about to sound 10 times better.
Beautiful.
It's happening.
Here we go. All right, guys, so here we have it.
That's it, S-line. Gosh. These come out to the exhaust tips.
Oh, yep, look at that.
They're like black chrome.
Oh my.
It's like Christmas.
Yep.
Jig for it and everything like that, but here the
headers. Piece of art. Okay, Christian, where are we at?
Making awesome progress, so I had to drop a few things out of the way because we're now at the header stage. So that means we already got the catalytic converters off.
So cats were right here. Remember, muffler goes here. That was already taken off. Cats go here. Those are off. The OEM headers are guaranteed to fail at some point in the car's life. So it's good to replace them as preventative maintenance and to get some more power and to have a great look, great sound, etc. So we're super excited for that. But look at that, the internals of the beast. Absolutely crazy, 4.3 liter V8. Here's a look at the carbon ceramic brakes, absolutely huge. But yeah, making great progress, looking good. Headers are off, look at the difference between these two.
Man, these suckers are heavy. So there's actually a cat inside the collector.
Check this out, check. All right, guys, see down there? That's a catalytic converter built into the headers. So that's why the stock headers are so restrictive. Whereas these, of course, there's nothing inside, no cats, no nothing. Just beautiful craftsmanship, really. Okay, guys, so check out the difference between the old catalytic converters. Look at the size of those. Two cats in each, four total with these parts. And now we are replacing those with these beauties.
Ah, light.
Good old test pipes, cat delete pipes. And then, not that you can call it a muffler because there is no muffler, just the X pipe. So this is the Sportline style. The X pipe is really what you need to get that really high pitched F1 sound, because otherwise you're kind of just running off 2 4 cylinders in a way. But once you combine them, it gives it that classic V8 high pitched Ferrari. So without further ado, let's install these bad boys. All right, Christian, final stretch, right? Give us an update.
Hey, buddy, down just the last hangers, pretty much.
He's working on the X pipe section, and then out come the pipes here to the tips. We're closing in on it.
So
All right, guys, so the car is being lowered. We are ready for first startup.
Dude, I'm so excited, guys. It's gonna be so loud.
Here we go, baby.
We're ready when you are. Rolling. All right.
Oh, God.
Let her in.
My ears just died.
In the arms of
oh my goodness, that was loud.
I'm just speechless.
I'm at a loss for
words. Oh boy.
Like, honestly.
That's the loudest thing I've ever heard in my life.
I think this might be the loudest V8 Ferrari in the world.
But it's beautifully loud. It is F1. It is a screamer.
That's louder than that.
Okay, well, we're just buttoning up the last parts right now. Yeah, I'm just like shaking. Give him a couple revs.
Of course.
Tanner was revving his GTR outside.
His is nothing compared to this.
I know.
My God.
What have we done? The butt dyno too. This thing's way faster.
Does it seriously feel faster?
Yes. Yes.
On center.
2,000 RPMs. Yeah.
You were this close to running over Andrew's foot. Stop! 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 Holy! I thought you were going over.
All right, got her loaded up.
3 hours later.
All right, guys. After a three-hour drive, we finally made it back to the warehouse. Here's the 430, still on the trailer, made it no problem. We're gonna go ahead and back it up to this curb so that it'll be easier to offload. There won't be as, you know, sharp of a grade. Boom, just like that. Now we don't have to use wood blocks because it really is kind of just a level grade.
I'm legitimately scared to start this car.
Yeah, honestly, like, we're like very scared to start this car. It's absolutely silent. There's no noises, and we're about to terrorize the entire block with this car. Oh boy. All right, let's do this. Okay, guys, we just cannot stop driving this car. I mean, it is beyond incredible. You'll notice right when we hit about 4,000 RPMs, you're really gonna get a pronounced sound. Right there. That's when the F1 craziness opens up. God, that's crazy. Absolutely incredible, but it's finally home, right behind the other screaming Ferrari, right behind the screaming Lamborghini. Boy, are we gonna have to do a rev battle.
So comment down below, do we need to do a rev battle between the 430, the 355, and the Gallardo? That would be absolutely insane. Okay, shut it down so I can talk.
Oh my gosh. No, I didn't, I wasn't looking.
Dude, that big pop that you heard was a big flame, bro.
Oh my God, this is insane.
How about that? That was crazy. I am still just trying to figure out what exactly this is, because it's like everything that we love. Ferrari 458, Ferrari 430, 355, all in one.
The pops and crackles were something I was not expecting at all. Well, then again, the pops and crackles are giant fireballs being spit out the back. So maybe that's why. Just incredible. Like we said, comment down below if you want to see a rev battle or a comparison between the other cars, but I think pretty much hands down this is going to win. This is, we're trying to think. We think it's probably one of the loudest Ferraris on the street
it's
right
the
now.
Loudest or, V8 Ferrari
or the loudest
in the world.
V8 Ferrari. It's insane, and you really do need to hear it in person because this is the best sounding car I think I've ever heard. Yep. And we've driven it for like 3 miles. Like, what? I can't wait to get here tomorrow, but we have been up for like 24 hours now. We're all super tired, and this video is getting long, but wow, the content in this video. Of course, we really hope you guys enjoyed, and huge thanks to Fast Speed, right? I mean, it just goes to show.
I mean, usually I'm full of things to say, but I don't really have anything to say, except they just killed it. They killed it on this.
Just too perfect, couldn't have worked out better. Extremely happy, and
just a test to their handcrafted, everything's made in-house with just all their high-quality materials,
and they
you
think
get what
about,
you pay for. Like, it's incredible.
And I think they're thinking about what they're making before they make it. They're really studying it hard and really doing all the development that they need
to get it right. of the company, and he was telling us his story about how he made this back in like 04.
Yeah, those headers he made in the summer of 2004 when this car first came out, and then they've been proven ever since to produce power, and they replaced the OEM ones, which failed.
Speaking of power, what do you think about the butt dyno?
Holy crap, the butt dyno is crazy.
Something else.
I think it's well, obviously it's producing way more horsepower and torque.
But only with that, we'll have to put it to the test in a following video for you guys. So can't wait for that. Can't wait to just drive it more. It's so late. We got
Wait a second. We're missing something. Doesn't he have to drive this car to high school now?
Oh, guess we have to. Dude, this would terrorize the high school. Like, the principals, cops would be called so fast. If you're new on the channel, be sure to subscribe. Like, definitely. If you're not subscribed already, you're missing a lot of good
content. It's gonna be a lot more of this car, obviously. So much to do with it, so.
Can't believe how it's
Can't wait. Great, crazy. Great start. Great start to this project, Budget Ferrari. So,
thank you guys so much for watching. See you in the next one. See you in a couple days.